Today in this video, we are going to see top 5 intellectual books which will be useful for competitive students in India, students who are writing the competitive exams. So I hope this 5 books will definitely help you, not only in increasing your knowledge base, but also getting few answers and getting few points in your examination. So first book I will suggest is Sapiens. This is written by Yuval Noah Harari. He is an Israeli Jewish historian. And let's talk about the content in this book. The major content of this book is the evolution of human, the process of evolution from archaic human to the present day sapiens. The second important content chunk in this book is how the cognitive evolution paved way for humans to rule other species, how the brain development, it is only because of the brain development we were able to control the other species. The third is how the myths like money, religion, God helped us to organize and work together to rule over other species. So these are the major contents in this book. And what is the advantage of reading this book is, like, even in 2019 prelims, there was a question called Denisova. This Denisova is nothing but a human species, archaic human species, which was found in a cave in Denisova. So the fossil was found there. And it was asked in UPSC 2019. So if you read this book, you may get, you would have got this question right. Another thing is, like, after reading this book, you will have definitely have a different perception of life. So let's go for the next book. The Argumentative Indian. This is written by Amartya Sen. And the major content of this book is about the debating culture which was present in ancient India. And he will even tell points like how even the loser's points, it remains alive in India. Like, there are people who still follow the loser in the debates. The one who lost the debate, his points also is alive. So that is the culture in India, that we respect everyone's view. And this is one of the reason why that democracy is still thriving in India. And he gives proof mentions some reference in ancient books that discrimination was not prevalent in ancient India, especially during the debate and other things. This will be helpful in subjects like Indian culture and ethics. So let's go for the next book. The next book is Poverty and Famine, and this is also by Amartya Sen. This is a path-breaking book when it was released. Like, he introduces a new concept in this book called exchange entitlement. I mean, he says that the failure in this exchange entitlement is the major reason for poverty and famine. Exchange entitlement means for me to have my food or to get grain, a bag of grain or rice. No, I have to exchange my labor or something which I have. When my capability to exchange is decreased, or if I'm not able to exchange something for the food, then famine occurs. So this is a very different point of view, and though it's not popular, this point of view, exchange failure and exchange entitlement, is not popular now, but it will be useful for you in economics paper. So let's go for the next book. The next book is The Fourth Industrial Revolution. It's written by Klaus Schwab. He's the founder and executive chairman of World Economic Forum, the global forum where the governments and NGOs discuss about economic policies. Now, in this book, he talks about the technological evolution that slowly is taking place, and we are not aware of it and we are not ready for it. So how we should get prepared to adapt it and how it will be helpful for us in the future generations. So he talks about these things. And it's definitely helpful for science and technology paper and economics paper in competitive exams. Next is Thinking Fast and Slow. This is written by Daniel Kahneman. He's a Nobel Prize winner in economics. Though he's a Nobel Prize winner in economics, the major concept is organizational behavior and behavioral economics. So it's more of a psychological oriented book. And it's a personality development. He introduces a concept that humans have two systems. System one, which is our intuition, and system two, which is our logical reasoning. But the problem is, most of the time we use our intuition. So about 70 to 80% of the time we use our intuition, rather than using our logical reasoning. And this is the reason why a lot of failures or decision, no, like we couldn't take proper decision. So this is the reason, like he says, where you have to take, you have to use the system one, and where you have to use the system two. He gives few examples and ideas in this book, and it's definitely useful to improve your personality as a whole, and can be useful in ethics paper too. So other honorable mentions are Homo Deus. Homo Deus is written by Yuval Noah Harari, the same author, the author of Sapiens. And Homo Deus is Homo is man, and Deus is God. God man, no, if he in this book, no, it's a continuation of Sapiens. He says that if allow human evolution without restricting it, then definitely human will reach a position where he will be able to conquer everything, and even reign most of the things that is present. And the other book is Billy Bryson. It's about a short history of nearly everything. It's just a very easy and fast. You can turn the pages fast, and it's it talks about everything from Big Bang theory to modern sapiens. Next is the Geography of Time, written by Robert V. Levine, and it talks about the cultural perspective of time, like how few people perceive and view the time in the, because of the cultural aspect. So these are the books which we think will be useful for students who are preparing for competitive exams. If you have any other suggestions or ideas, you can tell that in comment box, and if you like the video, you can definitely like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.